COP26 is the world's largest climate conference. It all started back in 1995 in Germany, and leaders from around the world have been reconvening every year since. However, this year is seen as different due to the world being at a pivotal point in the fight against climate change. With rising sea waters and climate disasters happening all over the world, leaders need to act immediately in order to prevent a climate disaster. Over the past 2 weeks, this event has been taking place in Glasgow, with a new protest almost every day. I attended one of the protests, and this is what happened.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to another vlog. So today we've got two things on the agenda. We're going to go to COP26 and we are going to go to a gin festival. Don't ask me how they tie together, they really don't. I know you guys have seen the title of this video, and let me explain before you jump on me. So typically what happens with protests is you're fighting against something. You're fighting against something happening and you're wanting something to change, which I would totally understand if COP26 wasn't currently happening, because I totally agree that we do need to do things to make the world more sustainable. However, the idea of COP26 is to make the world more sustainable, so that's why I don't really understand why people are protesting, and that's why right now I just don't really agree with them. Saying that, what we're going to do is we're going to head through to Glasgow, because I actually want to see what's going on. I'm probably wrong, lots of people disagree with me. So we're currently in Stirling right now, we're about to get the train, and we will see you guys in Glasgow. Peace. Right, so we just got into Glasgow Queen Street. There's protests going on somewhere, but we can already see the police presence. So we're going to go find the protest now. So this is what I've learned so far. First of all, they're campaigning for like multiple different reasons inside the bracket of climate change. First one I noticed was net zero. They don't actually want net zero, they want better than net zero. Second thing is greenwashing's a thing. So that's basically when companies add green to their logo just to make it look like they're doing something for climate change.
Or completely false advertising,
So basically making things green because it adds to the reputation but not actually doing anything about it. And it's peaceful. It's actually peaceful compared to a lot of other protests we've seen in past years. It's remained peaceful as far as we can see. And everybody's actually in really good spirits. They're all dancing, they're all happy, they're all cheery. So starting to like this protest. We're about to go check out George Square and see what that's like. So yeah, we will see you there. What's up, guys? So at this point I'm going to jump into the narrator just to explain things and all the groups that we actually saw from this point onwards. So first of all, we had the Red Rebel Brigade, and basically they're dressed this way because it symbolises the common blood that we share with all species, and which is ultimately what unifies us and makes us one. It kind of scared me, if you ask me. And then we had the people that were fighting for the indigenous people and their rights, and against colonialism. That word that's on the banner, basically. And then we have people who are fighting against the racism and racial injustice that are currently going on in this world.
There were people who looked like me, that when they wrote their name, they had no name. Not only did they have no name, but they said they had no value.
And then we have some Glaswegian who is shouting something. I don't really know what, but he seemed nice enough.
Help yourself! Listen to Mommy Lester!
Anyway, guys, just to emphasise, I cannot actually tell you the sheer size of this protest. Here's a quick time-lapse of it. Now, an hour after this point, they were still marching at this exact same spot, just a new group. So we have no idea how far it actually went. So I just looked at the footage, and basically I recorded an outro once we were in Stirling, explaining all my thoughts from the day. However, that footage turned out absolutely horribly. Just have a look at it. There's so many different aspects to it of what they're going to achieve. So basically my overall thoughts of it was that I now understand why people are protesting. It's for a lot more things than just climate change. And it's also about making sure there's a presence there and an awareness around why people are out protesting, why this actually matters so much, and how it actually affects people individually and on a personal basis. So with that being said, it's now the point of the video where we actually head to the gin festival, and well, this guy doesn't end up feeling too great afterwards. See ya!
Shots fired. Woo! Back to the future. Whoa. Catching air like I hit a floating Buddha. Whoa. Move bitch out the way like I'm Luda. I'm making moves like I'm doing Kama Sutra. Woo! Woo! Doing Kama Sutra. Whoa. Move bitch out the way like I'm Luda. Whoa. Whoa. Doing Kama Sutra. Whoa. Move bitch out the way.
Right, guys, we have a new goal today, and that is simply to get Andrew Duthie drunk.
I've got a report due Monday.
It's like lemon juice.
No, I ain't too flawless, and no, I ain't the best, and no, I don't say sorry, and no, I ain't perfect, but I am the man. Shots fired.